Hello and welcome to physicscatalyst.com. Let us start by looking at part A of this fill in the blanks. Now in part A of this fill in the blanks, we are given that we have a cube of side 1 centimeter. Now what we have to find is, we have to find the volume of the same cube in meter cube. So there are two ways to do it. First, you can convert this 1 centimeter into meter scale and then find the volume. Alternatively, what you can do is you can find the volume of cube of side 1 centimeter and the result will be in centimeter cube, and then convert this volume which is in centimeter cube to meter cube. Now we will tackle this question by first converting 1 centimeter into meter and then finding the volume of the cube. Now we all know that 1 centimeter is equal to 1 upon 100 meter, which is equal to 10 to the power minus 2 meter. Now length L is equals to 1 centimeter is equals to 10 to the power minus 2 meter. Therefore volume of the cube would be L cube is equals to 10 to the power minus 2 whole cube is equals to 10 to the power minus 6 meter cube. So this 10 to the power minus 6 is what you have to fill in your blank. Now look at part B of these fill in the blanks. Now here we have to find the surface area of a solid cylinder of radius R is equals to 2.0 centimeter and height H is equals to 10 centimeter. Now again this is also a question which involves the conversions of units. Like the part A of this fill in the blanks, where we have to convert centimeter into meter in order to find the answer. Now here we are given the radius and height in centimeter and we have to find the answer in millimeter. So first we would convert the radius and height from centimeter to millimeter. So we are given that R is equals to 2 centimeter and we know that 1 centimeter is equals to 10 millimeter. So in terms of millimeter, R is equals to 2 into 10 is equals to 20 millimeters. Now after radius, we will have to convert height H, which is equals to 10 centimeter into millimeter. So in terms of millimeter, height H would be 10 into 10 is equals to 100 millimeter. Now we know that surface area of a solid cylinder is equal to 2 pi r square plus 2 pi r h. Now putting the values, we get 2 into 3.14 into 20 whole square plus 2 into 3.14 into 20 into 100. We get 2512 plus 12560, which is equal to 15072 millimeter whole square, which we can also write as 1.5 into 10 to the power 4 millimeter whole square. Now let us look at part C of this question. Here we are given that a vehicle is moving with a speed of 18 kilometer per hour. Now we have to find the distance this vehicle covers in 1 second and the distance we have to find in units of meter. Now here also we would have to do the conversion of units, because speed is given in kilometer per hour and the time taken to cover the distance is given in seconds, and we have to find the distance in meters. So we have to convert the speed from kilometer per hour to meter per second. So we know that 1 kilometer is equals to 1000 meters and 1 hour is equals to 3600 seconds. So we are given that speed is equals to 18 kilometer per hour, which is equals to 18 into 1000 upon 3600. Okay, after calculating, this is equals to 5 meter per second. Therefore distance covered in 1 second is equals to 5 meters. Let us now look at the fourth part of this question. Now in this question we are being given the relative density of lead, that is 11.3, and we have to write its density in gram per centimeter cube and kg per meter cube. Now what is relative density? Relative density of a substance is the ratio of density of that substance to the density of another substance. Now since we are given relative density of lead is equals to 11.3, now density of water in terms of gram per centimeter cube is equals to 1 gram per centimeter cube. So density of lead in gram per centimeter cube would be equal to 11.2 gram per centimeter cube. Now to find the density of lead in kg per meter cube, we would have to convert gram into kilogram and centimeter into meter. So we know that 1 gram is equals to 1 upon 1000 kilogram is equals to 10 to the power minus 3 kilogram, and 1 centimeter is equals to 1 upon 100 meter is equals to 10 to the power minus 2 meter. So density in kg per meter cube can be expressed as 11.3 into 10 to the power minus 3 kg divided by 10 to the power minus 2 meter cube, which is equals to 11.3 into 10 to the power 3 kg per meter cube. Hello and welcome to physicscatalyst.com. Let us start by first looking at the statement of the question. The statement of the question requires us to fill in the blank by suitable conversion of unit. Now these type of questions can be simply solved by putting the respective conversion units in place. Let us now look at part A of the problem. Now part A of the problem requires us to convert kg meter square per second square to the unit gram centimeter whole square per second square. Now we know that 1 meter is equals to 100 centimeter, 1 kg is equals to 1000 grams. So 1 kg meter square per second square is equals to 1 into 10 to the power 3 grams into 10 to the power 2 centimeter whole square per second square. After calculating, we get it equal to 10 to the power 7 gram centimeter whole square per second whole square. So here 10 to the power 7 is the required answer. Now in second part of this question, we have to find that how many light years are there in 1 meter. To begin with, let us first define what is a light year. The distance traveled by light in 1 year is called 1 light year. Now we know that speed of light is equals to 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. Now, total number of seconds in 1 light year is equals to 365 into 24 into 60 into 60. Where 365 is number of days in a year. This number 24 is number of hours in a day. This number 60 is number of minutes in an hour. And this number 60 is number of seconds in a minute. So, 1 light year is equals to 3 into 10 to the power 8 into 365 into 24 into 60 into 60. So on calculating, we find 1 light year is equals to 9.46 into 10 to the power 15 meter. Therefore, 1 meter is equals to 1 upon 9.46 into 10 to the power 15, which is equal to 1.053 into 10 to the power minus 16 light year. So this is your required answer. In third part of this question, we have to convert 3 meter per second square to kilometer per hour square. Now here we have to convert meter to kilometers and second to hours. Now we know that 1 kilometer is equals to 1000 meter and 1 hour is equals to 3600 seconds. So now using this value, we have 3 meter per second whole square is equals to 3 into 10 to the power minus 3 kilometers into 1 upon 3600 hours to the power minus 2, which is equals to 3 into 10 to the power minus 3 into 3600 into 3600 kilometer per hour square, which is equals to 3.88 into 10 to the power 4 kilometer per hour square. We can roughly state this quantity as 3.9 into 10 to the power 4 kilometer per hour whole square, and this number is your required answer. Here in fourth part of the question, we have to convert the units of gravitational constant from SI units to CGS units. Now in terms of kg, meters and second, unit of force newton is written as kg meter per second whole square. So we get g is equals to 6.67 into 10 to the power minus 11 kg meter per second whole square into meter whole square kg to the power minus 2. Now we have to sort out the power of these units. So now we have kg 1 plus minus 2 meter 1 plus 2 and second to the power 0 plus minus 2. So finally we have 6.67 into 10 to the power minus 11 meter cube second to the power minus 2 and kg has a power of minus 1. Now we all know that 1 meter is equals to 100 centimeter, 1 kg is equals to 1000 grams. So putting these conversion values, we get 6.67 into 10 to the power minus 11 into 10 to the power 6 centimeter cube second to the power minus 2 into 10 to the power minus 3 gram to the power minus 1. Now sorting out the powers of 10, we get g equals to 6.67 into 10 to the power minus 8 centimeter cube second to the power minus 2 and grams to the power minus 1. Now this quantity, this number here is your required answer.
Hello and welcome to physicscatalyst.com. Let us start by looking at the question. Now question we are given is that a calorie is a unit of energy and it is equal to 4.2 joules, where 1 joule is equals to 1 kg meter square per second square. Now suppose we employ a system of unit in which the unit of mass is alpha kg, the unit of length equals beta meter and the unit of time is gamma second. Show that a calorie has a magnitude of 4.2 alpha to the power minus 1, beta to the power minus 2 and gamma square in terms of new unit. So basically what we have to do in this question is the conversion of system of units. So it is given that 1 calorie is equals to 4.2 joules. And it is also given that 1 joule is equals to 1 kg meter whole square per second square. So 1 calorie is equals to 4.2 kg meter whole square per second whole square. Now if we want to convert physical quantity from one system of unit to another, then we must keep in mind that the magnitude of a physical quantity remains the same whatever may be the system of units. So if U1 and U2 are the units of measurement of any physical quantity and N1 and N2 are corresponding numerical values, then N1 U1 is equals to N2 U2. Now we know that dimension of energy is m l to the power 2 t to the power minus 2. So we have a is equals to 1, b is equals to 2 and c is equals to minus 2. Now in SI units we have n1 is equals to 4.2, M1 is equals to 1 kg, L1 is equals to 1 meter and T1 is equals to 1 second. And in new system of unit, we have to find N2. Here M2 is equals to alpha kg, L2 is equals to beta meter and T2 is equals to gamma second.
Now from relation N1 U1 is equals to N2 U2, we have N2 is equals to N1 U1 upon U2, or we have N2 is equals to N1 M1 upon M2 to the power A, L1 upon L2 to the power B, and T1 upon T2 to the power C. Now putting in respective value of A, B and C, we get N2 is equals to 4.1 kg upon alpha kg to the power 1 meter upon beta meter to the power 2, and 1 second upon gamma second to the power minus 2. Simplifying it, we get N2 is equals to 4.2 alpha to the power minus 1, beta to the power minus 2, and gamma to the power 2. Hence, 1 calorie is equals to 4.2 joules, which in new system of unit equals 4.2 alpha to the power minus 1, beta to the power minus 2, and gamma to the power 2, where alpha inverse is new unit of mass, beta to the power minus 2 is new unit of length, and gamma square is new unit of time. Hello and welcome to physicscatalyst.com. Let's begin with the question. In first part of the question, we have to explain the statement correctly. The statement is, to call a dimensional quantity large or small is meaningless without specifying a standard for comparison. Now, the given statement is correct because measurement is basically a comparison process. But without specifying standard for comparison, it is not possible to get an exact idea about the magnitude of the dimensional quantity. Now, for example, we say that mass of Earth is very large. Now, this statement is meaningless. We all know that mass of Earth is large, but in comparison of what? Are we comparing it with another planet, for example, Jupiter or Sun? Obviously, mass of Earth is very small in comparison to Jupiter or Sun. So, in this statement, we have to specify in comparison to what or in comparison to which object we are trying to say that mass of Earth is large. So, to correct the statement, we can say that mass of the Earth is large, or in fact very large, in comparison to any object that lie on its surface. So, we are comparing mass of Earth with the objects that lie on its surface. And definitely, mass of Earth is very large in comparison to anything that lie on its surface. Now, in second part of the question, we have to rephrase the statements. Now, consider the first statement, which states that atoms are very small objects. Yes, atoms are small, but we cannot just state small. To get an idea of how small, we have to tell about the object we are comparing it with. Now, atoms are so small, even if we compare it to the size of a needle tip or a grain of sand. So, the correct statement might be, the size of atom is much smaller than even the sharp tip of a pin. Now, the second statement is, a jet plane moves with a great speed. Again, the comparison is missing here. So, we can rephrase the statement as, a jet plane moves with a speed greater than that of a super fast train. So, here we are comparing speed of jet plane with that of a super fast train. Now, the third statement is the mass of Jupiter is very large. Again, this statement is incomplete. We are stating that mass of the Jupiter is very large, but we have not talked about the comparison. In comparison of which object, which planet, we are comparing the mass of Jupiter. So, the correct statement could be, the mass of Jupiter is very large compared to that of Earth. So here, while writing the statement, you can compare the mass of Jupiter with that of the Earth. Now the fourth statement is, the air inside this room contains a large number of molecules. We all know air inside any room consists of large number of molecules, but comparison is missing here in this statement. So we can rephrase this statement as, the air inside this room contains more number of molecules than one mole of air. So we are making comparison of the amount of air inside the room with one mole of air. Now fifth statement is, a proton is much more massive than an electron. This statement does not need any rephrasing because we are already comparing the mass of proton with that of an electron, and definitely proton has more mass than that of an electron. Now sixth statement is, speed of sound is much smaller than the speed of light. Again, this statement does not need rephrasing as we are comparing speed of sound with that of light and we do not require any change. Hello and welcome to physicscatalyst.com. Let us now begin with our question. A question is, a new unit of length is chosen such that the speed of light in vacuum is unity. What is the distance between the sun and the earth in terms of the new unit if light takes 8 minutes and 20 seconds to cover this distance? Let us now look at its solution. We know that speed of light is equals to 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. Now, this unit is defined in meter per second. According to question, this unit is changed and now it is velocity or speed of light is equals to 1 new unit of length per second, where this NL is new unit of length. Now, time taken by light from sun to reach earth is given as t is equals to 8 minutes and 20 seconds. Now, if we convert these 8 minutes into second, we get 8 into 60 plus 20 is equals to 500 seconds. Now, distance between sun and earth is x is equals to c times t, where c is the velocity of light, and this velocity of light, as stated in question, take 8 minutes and 20 seconds or 500 seconds to reach from sun to earth. Now here c is 1 new unit of length per second and t, as we calculated above, is 500 seconds. So in terms of these new units of light, distance between sun and earth is 1 into 500 is equals to 500 new unit of length.